Hey, what's up, everyone? We are back with another tutorial in Cubase Elements 8. Today we're going to learn how to sample and slice, which is good if you're making hip-hop music, but it's really good for just about anything. So, let's take a look at this track I've recorded. You'll see it right here. It's called Boots and Cats.
Boots and Cats.
That's a lovely track. So, as many of you know, the foundation of all beats are boots and cats, boots and cats, and boots and cats, and boots and cats, and boots and cats. So we're gonna chop up my boots and cats here and make a little beat. So in order to do that, we need to use Groove Agent, which is an awesome tool included with Cubase Elements 8. So let me actually walk through this so nobody gets confused. Add instrument track. You can add it by right-clicking or clicking this thing, add instrument track. And when it chooses instrument, I choose drum. There's Groove Agent SE. Add track. And I usually work in two monitors, so if I'm a little bit clunky, forgive me. But here's our boots. We know that to be true. And we'll move that. Just slide it right here into our first pad. And here's our and. I chopped it up earlier, but you can chop it up with the range selection tool as well. And here is our cats. Oops. Boom. So now we have
boots and cats and boots and cats and boots and cats.
And of course, on a MIDI controller, it'll look a little something like this.
Boots and cats and boots and cats and boots and.
So now you have yourself a little drum set that you've made, and I'm going to just play this Stevie Wonder song. We'll teach you how to chop that up in a second, and then play my boots and cats along with it. So I have Groove Agent open.
Boots and cats and boots and cats and.
So let's play this.
Boots, cats, boots, cats, boots, cats, boots, cats, boots.
You get the idea, boots and cats, that's how you do it. So now, if you right click on this pad, you can reset all pads. And let's chop up a little Stevie Wonder. And I warn you that if you're going to use this for commercial purposes, you should certainly clear your samples first. However, I feel like since this is an educational video, it's pretty much fair use, I think. So let's listen to the Stevie Wonder song real quick. That's what we want. We want the first two bars, really. So we just select them. Now I actually have the tempo locked in, but it's okay. And then let me bring back Groove Agent and just drag the whole thing to Groove Agent, which is sick. And then you can create slices. So if your Groove Agent's open, this might be your first screen or whatever. You go to this tab right here, Slice, and you create slices. And it'll do it on transients. That's what it defaults to. You'll see this mode here, transient. But for this purpose, we'll switch it to grid. And we will choose eighth notes because we want each of those hits to be a thing. So it's... Oh. So you have each of those hits... Really, you can hear them like this. And that's how you slice things up. Let's say you wanted to manually add the slices. Well, here's the secret to this. In Groove Agent, no one will tell you this, but you actually have to hold the Alt key, and then you can create slices just by left-clicking. On a Mac, I don't know what Alt is equivalent to. Maybe Command or Option or Control or... I don't know. It's a different world. But once those slices are set, you can see on the MIDI controller. So you can use that however you'd like. let's get rid of all these samples. And let's pull in Reset All Pads. Right click, Reset All Pads from the one you started with. We'll move this out of the way. Then I also have another loop here. I think the whole thing is a loop that I just made. Right up here, we'll make this smaller. This is the Rubber Band Man by the Spinners. And we'll just drag that into Groove Agent. We can create slices. And, oh, you have to have Groove Agent selected. But I don't like that, so let's do a grid and maybe select eighth notes. And then, so you can grab out whatever you want if you use manual as well. So you, if you just want this first horn hit, boom. And then you want, you know, a little bit of drums action, you know, you alt click. What if you want that to go continuous though? This is where we're going to get into the sample tab on your Groove Agent. This is no loop right now. I think it might default to one shot. But you can do continuous. Hey. And then you have to go to this pad to select continuous. You have to click on the pad. Cool, huh? And you can reverse it. So let's say I want to reverse the horn. And then make it an until release. Yeah, it sounds obnoxious, but those are things you can do. I think that basically covers everything I was going to talk about in terms of sampling and slicing. I hope you found it helpful. Take care, everyone, and have a very good day. Bye.